My name is Manny Tick Huerta. I'm 26 years old. I'm originally from the United States of America. Right now, I'm training out of Phuket, Thailand. Growing up, I wasn't into sports at all because I'm a tiny person, you know? So most sports back in America, you gotta be a giant, you know? So I didn't really do anything that was like a team sport just because I was always at a disadvantage. But once I started competing in jiu-jitsu and competing in martial arts, I was able to find people my size. I like having pressure on me. You know, I don't like having to rely on someone during competition because I know at the end of the day, when I'm inside of the ring and I'm competing, it's just me and I can't point fingers at nobody else. I thrive and I succeed at that. My biggest sacrifice really is just the time from my family, my brothers. I left home when I was like 20 years old, so I came to realize quite recently that I missed seeing my little brothers grow up being there. I wasn't able to just be there and lead by example of being there, but I was able to lead by example of, you know, following a dream, I guess. But the hardest part was just sacrificing family. I absolutely believe the sacrifice will be worth it soon because my brothers, they wrestle, they compete. I know that I've inspired them and I've inspired other people to follow their passion, follow their dream. The scariest thing in the world to me is to have a 9-to-5, and that's all I do, is I go to work, I go home, and that's it. Competing is scary, but I know that when I'm an old man, I rest my head and it's my time, that I did what I love and there's no regrets about it. I used to have like a little drinking problem. Like, there was nothing major like where I was drinking like all the time. It was just like a coping mechanism that I didn't realize that I was having. And I was in a kind of, at the time, I was in a pretty like abusive relationship, like verbally. And I didn't realize till like you take a step back and you look and see what's going on. Doing those things that was being done to me onto other people. And I realized like I was just taking everything out on people that didn't deserve it. And so I just made a decision to cut it out. Like when I was drinking, like at the time, I wasn't in the right like headspace. So yeah, right now I've been a year sober. And it's been easy because I didn't drink very often. It was just what I would do to when I was angry or sad, just being young and dumb. The verbal abuse was coming more from my previous girlfriend. She was just very vicious with her words and just, she would put me down a lot, you know? Like my job at my other gym was to mop the mats and clean the toilets, and she would remind me like, that's what you do, that's who you are. It would kind of cut me deep, you know?
So we're headed off to wrestling practice. I'm gonna show you guys the long journey I had to take in order to get to top team.
Oh, here we are. What I like most about living in Thailand, and specifically on this street, Soi Thaiet, is that everybody has the same common goal, to better themselves and to be a good martial artist and to experience life and enjoy life. That's what I'm all about, is just enjoying life, enjoying this journey.
We just finished up our wrestling practice.
Yeah, I don't want to be smelling on the mat.
Beautiful scenery here.
When I first started just doing jiu-jitsu. I started with kind of everything, but jiu-jitsu was my main focus. For competition, I listened to my coaches. You know, I know that like, in order to win, I need to be in here. I need to test myself, I need to push myself. I need to rest when I need to rest, but I also need to know when I'm just being a baby about things. But I trust my coaches, I trust my friends, and I prepare, just, I come in.
These pictures that I have here, they're me training with some of the highest level guys. This here is me winning, you know? So every time I walk out of my door, I see me with my arms raised and me winning.
I did one jiu-jitsu tournament, and then quickly after that, I had my very first amateur MMA fight. The way I would describe that was like someone threw water on a cat and they just kind of spazzed out. You can see I was just like a little kid, like figuring this stuff out. I was inside of the ring with Big John McCarthy, and he raised my hand, so I was like, I already felt like I reached the big time. I was like, I'm destined for this. And I knew that from that second that this is what I was supposed to do. The easiest thing to do is just show up. I show up to practice, I get better. So that's what I did when I was back home. I started from nothing. You know, like I was just like a little kid that knew some grappling, but I showed up every day. I didn't stop, I get my butt kicked. I just keep that mentality of just show up, just show up, just show up. I perform well. I do what I do. This is what I do for a living. This is what I do as a passion. When I practice the way I plan on competing. And after the tryout, I just told myself, this is what you do every day. This is your life. Just have fun. Do what you do. It's nothing different. But when Rich told me I was selected for the One Warrior Series, I was pretty surreal, you know, almost like, whoa, no way. Really? Cool. Sweet. All right.
Watching you grapple, real smooth stuff, man. Just the way you transition.
You know, so that I've been working towards something big for a while, and this was it, and I was pretty, like, couldn't believe it, you know? It's pretty awesome.
Thank you so much. It's awesome, man. Congratulations again.
Yeah, good tryout today. Really impressive stuff. I like watching you.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Yeah.